So the area of science that my lab works in is based on the body's text messages. So it's like tiny little bubbles that can be used to communicate between different areas of your body. The scientific term is extracellular vesicles that cells can send to each other over short distances, but also over longer distances from one organ to the other. So for example, we can take somebody's blood and we can find those text messages that are beneficial and we can further engineer them with therapeutic properties and inject them back in. On the other hand, looking at the bad text messages or extracellular vesicles, we're looking at cancer cells, particularly breast cancer, because breast cancer can be quite aggressive. And we're looking at the sugars that are part of these bubbles and seeing how those extracellular vesicle sugars help the cancer spread and hide from the immune system. And if we figure out how these extracellular vesicles are helping the cancer, then we can also develop therapeutic strategies to block that and hopefully help patients that are suffering from breast cancer. The average time to get a medicine from the lab to the medicine cabinet is 12 years and $2.7 billion. So it is a big challenge. By, you know, having the greatest expertise and team involved, we can try to overcome some of those hurdles and translate into the clinic with our clinician collaborators. In order to help patients, it's crucial to have those industry partners, and they can help guide our research early on so that we can make it applicable to eventually going into the clinic. And throughout my work, we work with those partners to look at things like scalability. Can we produce enough therapeutics to eventually save lives? And so it's very important to have that industry perspective early on. And so I welcome anyone who's interested in the field of extracellular vesicles to reach out to our lab and the AIBN in general to discuss ways that we can work together.